just toilet paper and hand sanitizer, some retailers say ammo is also just flying off the shelves. Stores say this is the latest item to go following the coronavirus concerns. And tonight, a local gun shop is weighing in. Fox Carolyn is sharpshooters in Greenville County tonight. So, Brooklyn, what are they saying?
Well, I've talked to several local retailers here around the upstate, and they all have a similar story. They say they're either completely sold out of ammo or almost gone. And they say this isn't just happening here in South Carolina, but across the nation.
As shoppers hit the stores and stock up on everything from cleaning supplies to paper products, an unlikely item is also on the list.
I guess same reason as toilet paper and everything else is.
Jim Brazel is the general manager of Sharpshooters in Greenville. He says they've had a record number of customers buying ammunition over the past few weeks, something he's never witnessed before.
I've been in this business now going on 9 years working here, and I've seen it like this at all.
Brazel says people are uneasy about the coronavirus and growing concerns about their personal safety.
People think they need to panic over this coronavirus that's going around.
He says some people have told him they're buying because of fear of the unknown.
Other people just like, you know, well, I feel like I need to get it because everybody else is.
Brazel says they're completely sold out of ammo except for a small stock reserved for the gun range.
I've had people come in today say they've checked all over the state and can't find any at all. Well, apparently it's just there's so many people buying it in bulk that the distributors we deal with don't have any to send out, and what we've got in the store is what we've got until we get more, and right now we have no idea when that's going to be.
And I also reached out to Cabela's and Academy, and both stores say they are sold out of many popular calibers, including 9mm. Live in Greenville, Brooklyn Cromer, Fox Carolina, the 10 o'clock news.